is the energy vibration reading for the Cancers for the month of July. Okay, so thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. Thank you for the wonderful support, likes, and shares. It is the month of July, and the month of July, I am dedicating to a special subscribers. She have helped us to make this month special with these new card decks that we're using. So as you can see, the month is dedicated to the month of July. This is a deck we got from Sadie, a subscriber who have donated some card decks so that we can keep the general readings going. Okay, so for a private reading, please use the website below this video, and please like, shares, and thumbs up. Thank you for being here. Thank you for coming back. And it's going to be a wonderful month of July for you guys, because the energy vibration is the energy of the heart. The two first weeks is water, so the two first weeks are going to be good for you guys. The two last week is fire energy, so, and it's passion, fire and passion, so be aware of that. Okay, so let's look at what you have. You have the energy of the sun. I love this deck. This deck is the Kathye deck, and it's a positive deck. I love it. It's simpler, it cut to the chase, it say exactly what is coming up for the month of July. So for you Cancers, I want to say thank you for the support, the likes and shares. Listen to your sun, moon, and rising sign. Please listen to the third quarter videos also. That is already uploaded. It is, and go back each and every month, July, August, September, to see the message that is there. So what is coming up for the Cancers in the first week? You have the energy of the Three of Wands. So you Cancers will be leaving something behind in the month of June, coming in July in the first week. This is going to be good for some of you. Whatever conflicts there is, or injustice and imbalance, you are turning your back towards this, and you're moving forward in a positive direction. Okay, in the second week, you have the energy of the Nine of Swords. The second week, you have the energy of the Nine of Swords. Whatever is happening in the second week, it has to do with your own energy vibration, zodiac energy vibration that you'll be having. And it has to do with something with yourself, because you're worried. There's a lot of worries. So it's something within you that you're worrying about in the second week. Okay, so be aware of your thoughts in the second week, and we need to change the energy vibration of worries to saying to the universe, what exactly do you want? Call upon your angels and said, this is a situation, I need help in this, or I need help in that, and the universe and the angels will help you. Okay, let's see what the Cancers have in the third week. You have the energy of the Page of Pentacles. So there's a message that is coming in. This is going to be about work. So if you because the general energy of the third week is the energy of the Emperor, so it could be a message of receiving a salary increase, or you're receiving a new job that is going to be paying much better. So this is a good sign as we look forward and we move forward to see what's coming out for the fourth week of July for the Cancer sun, moon, and rising sign. Let's see what we have. We have the energy of the Five of Swords conflict. Okay, so you know, the energy of the sun is your energy vibration. So what's happening is that all these conflicts and situation that is happening in your life is going to basically resolve in the month of July. Okay, so let's see, because what I'm receiving is that whatever the conflicts, whatever the situation that you were going through that was not really positive in the month of June, you're turning your back on that and you're moving forward, but you're worried about how is it you're going to be moving forward. And the Page of Pentacles come, and there is some conflicts with situation. But for work, I'm seeing that there are conflicts in the last week with group of mentors. So let's see what's happening for the first week going in the second week. You have the Seven of Pentacles, the energy of the Seven of Pentacles. First week going in the second week, we have the energy of the Seven of Pentacles. And this is good because whatever that has been happening and whatever that has been going on, whatever the worries is, it's going to be okay. Because you are trying to change the energies of whatever that was in the past and making a better future, okay? Let's see what is coming out from the second week to the third week. We have the energy of the Queen of Pentacles. This is someone who is over the age of 40. This is someone who is over the age of 40. And some of you are worried about this person. This person could be your partner. And this person could be your partner or is someone that you are in business with. Okay, this person could be a partner or someone you're in business with. As we move forward and we're looking at the outcomes of with the third week and the fourth week, third week and fourth week for the Cancers, the 8th, the 10 of Pentacles. So this is wonderful, wonderful, you Cancer. So whatever is happening, you are going to receive message that you're about to receive some money, but there are conflicts with the organization. There is huge conflicts with the organization. So it could be that you have ended a work situation in the month of June coming into July, and the payments, the help payments should be coming into you, but there is conflicts in as an organization, and you will receive the message that the money is coming through, but there are some conflicts in the organization. What I can also say is that for some of you, Cancer, there will be it could be a situation where you have divorced someone who is over the age of 40, that is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn, okay? This is a situation where, you know, you have to pay the money out, but you're in conflict with this person to do it because you just don't want to do it, and you need to do it because it's going to affect you if you don't do it, because it's as if you have done something injustice to this person. As we move forward and we look at the situation with the Seven of Pentacles and the Queen, you're trying to find inner guidance as to how to move forward with this person. This could be your wife or you're in a long distance relationship with this person, and there has been a lot of situation that is going on, a lot of worries, and you're looking within to come up with an idea of how to deal with a situation, because the Nine of Swords is over this energy, and this energy is going within to find the true purpose and the true meaning and to find a way how to resolve this situation. Okay, some of you could be worried that you haven't heard from this person, or you could be worried that, you know, you have lost someone, lost this person because of stupidity. And you haven't heard from this person, and you are now worried that you will never hear from this person. This is what I'm receiving, that because of some stupidity, some stupid thing that happened, this person walked away or left your life, and you are now worried about, you know, if I will have her, did I do things right? Was I correct in doing, in acting in the way that I act? Was my motivation, was at the highest level? And this is what you're thinking about, because you're very worried in the second week about this person, because it's as if you built up something, you have some feelings about this lady who is a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, and this person left your life and walk away, and you're worried about this. Some of you who are married or divorced to a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, you'll be receiving message from her that she needs financial support, or the child needs financial support. But there is a lot of situation coming up in the third week about kids and custody battle and kids. You need to pay for a child, and there is conflicts about money that you need to pay for this child. Okay, so there is a lot of conflicts that you have going on. Queen of Pentacles and the Ten of Pentacles. What should we know? There's a judgment. There is a judgment call. There is a judgment call. Whatever this judgment call is, because most of you have been looking for inner guidance and information is about to come to you. Information can be coming from the worries about the Queen of Pentacles. There can be information that is going to be coming in about her or from her. I'm thinking that is from her. Let's see what is going to be the outcomes. The Six of Cups. Now the Six of Cups, obviously it's a family situation that is going on. So you guys are going through a family situation with this Queen of Pentacles. As I've said, this Queen of Pentacles could be your kid mother, and you're trying to figure out and look at the situation because there is something that is going on there. And obviously, the outcomes of this month is the Six of Cups. The Six of Cups is family. As immediate family, the family you were born in, or soul family. So it's as if the first week you're leaving a situation behind and you're trying to build on something new. You're looking for inner guidance to do this. The last week you have a situation of conflicts with money. And there's a judgment call, and it has to do with family or close immediate family. Okay, the energy of the Page of Cups, there's a lot of situation that is happening with kids in this week. There is a judgment call about money, and there is a lot of situation that is happening with kids in this week. Whatever the situation is, whatever the transformation is that is going on. And that last week, you are going to be having situation, and it has to do with money. It's money. You're going to receive message about money about with this kid. The second week and third week is there. Some of you will be worrying about your child. Okay, it could be a situation where you're worried about your child. Maybe there is it's as if you have a new baby or baby that is about a year or so, between a year and 5 years, and you're worried about this child for some reason, and you know, you're wishing and hoping that things was different. For some of you, it's as if the hospital find something wrong. It's as if the hospital find that something is wrong with this child, and you know, there's a lot of worries, and you need help, and you know you're hoping to hear something from a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn woman over the age of 40. Okay, now whoever this lady is, it's on your mind. This person is on your mind. It's basically, it can be your mom. Some of you could be worried about your mom. If she's a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn, some of you are going to be very worried about your mom. Okay, you're going to be looking inwards to find the truth of a situation and to kind of ease out and understand exactly what is going on. Okay, some of you could be receiving message that your kid or your mom is sick. This is what is coming out, and you're going to be looking for inner guidance. Love is going to be there for you. I'm seeing some of you have strong feelings. It's all about, it's as if this, whoever the Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn person is always on your mind. Okay, this month I've changed up the reading, and we're doing the speaker reading. The speaker reading is a way of seeing what was happening. There's a lot of conversation that is going on, a lot of communications that is going on in the first week, a lot of conversation, a lot of situation in the first week about your stability, okay? A lot of conversation that is going on about your stability, and you are going to be finding out that you have different choices to make in the first week. So a lot of conversation about your stability because you decide to leave something behind. And you are going to be wondering which way, which direction to go. And there are going to be a lot of openings that is going to be happening for you. As we look at the second and third week to see what is going to be happening, the conversation that are happening is going to be clearing up the blockage, and peace is going to be coming in. So this is wonderful because whoever have a situation with a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn woman over the age of 40, what you're going to see is that peace is coming in for this situation once and for all, okay? And luck is going to be coming in. There are going to be a lot of new opportunities opening up for you guys. As we look at the fourth week, see what energies are coming out in the fourth week. We have some of you could be traveling in the fourth week. I'm seeing a lot of traveling. This can be vacation, or this can be visiting relatives overseas, or this could be business. So there is a lot of traveling, a lot of people that is, and then you're going to be meeting up with a friend. Some of you could be traveling to see a friend, meeting up with a friend in the last week. This is going to be positive because it's going to be bring out a positive outcome to situations in your life, a very, very positive outcomes to situation in your life, okay? Now, this energy comes up, and it can be an energy of luck is going to be coming in very fast, but it can be an energy that there is going to be the ending of a relationship with someone overseas, okay? So, whatever is happening, this energy is, it can be for fast luck, and it can be the end of a theft and the end of a karmatic situation that you were going through. The end of a theft and the end of a karmatic situation that you were going through, okay? End of a theft, end of a karmatic situation that you were going through, okay? So there is going to be balance coming in. We're asking what is going to be the outcomes, what is going to be the last thing in the fourth week for the Cancers. An invitation is going to be coming in. So if I look at your reading, a very diagonal, there is a lot of talk. A lot of conversation that is happening. Finally, peace is going to be coming, and an invitation is going to be coming in. From the past, from the first week going to the fourth week, there are multiple opportunities that is going to be coming up for you, and a new situation is going to be formulating in your life. Some of you are going to be traveling. Some of you are going to be moving away and moving somewhere else. Okay, so this is actually good. As we read the cross of what is going to be taking place in the second week and the third week, whatever the blockage was, there is going to finally come peace, and there is going to become a lot of luck, a lot of lucky breaks coming in for some of you. And as we look at the cross, because the cross is like this, horizontal. It's your stability, peace is going to be coming, and you're going to be connecting with friends. So the outcome, you have twice for the sun, twice the energy of the sun. You have twice the energy of the sun. So all the situation that was happening in the month of June and the months before. This is going to be coming out. If you're deciding to start a business, it's going to be a good month. If you're starting a new relationship, it's going to be a good month. Love is going to be coming in this month, but yet still success is also going to be here. But you are going to be finding yourself again. You're going to be releasing all of the negative situation that has been happening to you. Okay, so basically it is a wonderful month. It doesn't look like that in the general reading, but with the mirror reading you can see, because these are just the general reading is showing you the obstacles that you have to overcome, and these obstacles are all going to be resolved. So there's a fast ending to the theft that has transpired, and it was a karmatic situation. Okay, so for you Cancers, we're using another deck from Sadie. So send positive energies to Sadie and healing energies, and you guys have let's get my glasses on. You guys have life lessons. So it's all about life lessons and an healing coming in. Okay, it says you can break free from the recurring negative patterns by praying to know the lesson and blessings they contain. Okay, so obviously there was a lesson that was happening in the past for you that is finally going to be clearing up in the future for you, and in a positive way. So see this month as a month of you looking in to see what was the lessons that you have learned from a situation. And this situation could be with your mother's child that is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn, or just your mother's your child's mother, or it could be a situation with your mom, because I'm seeing the energy of your mom also. So if your mom is a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, or has the energy vibration in their chart as a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, this is what is coming out. So obviously it's a karmatic situation. If there was theft that had taken place in your life, this is going to be resolved. It's the end. Okay, an end has come to this. Ladies and gentlemen, please listen to the sun, moon, and rising sign, and I'm saying namaste until next time.